morning. Welcome. Who's this?
This is Mike.
Mike, what can I do for you?
Oh, I just like to express my views on my fiance. How much she's brought me back to life after my wife passed away.
I like that you want to express your views on someone you love, because, you know, some shows want to express their views about politics or sports or current issues, and we're not here to do that. We're just here to talk about love. So, Mike, tell me about your beloved.
Well, I had lost my wife, and I figured I was married to her for 10 years, and I thought, well, you know, that was my allotment of happiness in my life. And I was at a Walmart, and I met her on the 4th of July. Well, I called her on the 5th and asked if I could come over, and I just wanted to talk to her. Well, we talked, all right. We talked for 13 straight hours, and I knew there and then that I found happiness again. And we've been with each other since that moment, and she brought color back into my world. She brought me back to life again, and I can't see me not seeing her at least once every day. I can't stand not being with her.
Mike, what's her name?
Her name is Dana.
All right, let me see what I can do for you, too.
Thank you very much, Delilah.
Bye-bye.
And good day.
We're in the home stretch of the hard times. We took a hard left, but we're all right. Yeah, life sure can try to put love to it, but we built this right, so nothing's ever gonna move it. When the bones are good, the rest don't matter. Yeah, the pain could peel, the glass could shatter. Let it rain, there's you and I remain the same. When there ain't a crack in my foundation,
tries to cover up her pain and cut her woes away.
faces made, but there's a hope that's waiting for you.
Have bloomed out, but this time of year my lavender is in bloom. I've been harvesting lavender the last few weeks and hanging it in the house to dry, and it smells heavenly. I walk in and it just kisses me on the cheek, that delightful, relaxing smell of lavender. I love being out in the garden. I love working in the soil, and you know what? Gardening is a lot like life. It's a lot like my faith. If I turn my back on my garden for even a week or two, whoo, it's not good. The weeds take hold in no time at all, and they threaten to choke out everything beautiful. So it is with my faith and my life. If I don't tend the garden of my soul, if I don't take good care of the beautiful things God has planted in the garden of my soul, generosity, kindness, honesty, integrity, those things, if I don't pay attention to those things, the weeds of neglect will choke them out. Selfishness, self-centeredness, laziness, gossip, all those bad habits that I have, my anger, my temper, all those things will take over and choke out the goodness my life if I don't tend the garden of my soul. So if you have a real garden, I invite you to garden with me. But I also invite you to tend the garden of your soul, the garden of your heart, and make sure those weeds like gossip, insecurity, jealousy, possessiveness, greed, ego, all those things are kept in check, lest they choke out the beautiful flowers in your heart. We'll be back. You're listening to Delilah.